save me, Kuz. Save me from this. let's talk some hockey here. Can we do this? I've just got my ass kicked in our fantasy draft. So anyway, I want to talk like everybody else is about Pettersson, right? The hype is just great because it's what it is, and the fans are starved for this. Can he keep this up? I mean, this is what we've been kicking around this morning. He's got a 6-game road trip.
What's the enticing thing about Pettersson isn't just that what he's doing offensively, guys. It's he's not one-dimensional, and I'm sure DT would approve of this as a former player. You talk to guys in the room, and talking to guys after the game, the opener, I was talking to Branson. He said, listen, this guy, through the neutral zone, on the back check, will strip guys off pucks. He's so responsible. He comes all the way back into the zone. Great support. Doesn't cheat. Doesn't quit. Doesn't cherry pick. Whoever coaches this guy in Sweden, the Canucks may want to give him a call and, I don't know, maybe arrange a little trip for him, because I've never seen a kid 19 do what he's doing, in the sense that his responsibility and his awareness. I remember one play in the open, he had the puck in the offensive zone in the corner, and it looked like he was almost going to do one of those, you know what, I'm going to throw the puck between my legs and it's going to hit somebody, but he sort of took a quick look around. What he did, he protected the puck along the wall until he got some support. I mean, this is the kind of stuff you can't teach. So I understand all the hype, because why not? I mean, this isn't just like somebody showed up and we hope he can play at this level. I mean, this was the MVP in the Swedish Hockey League. Okay, can he acclimate to this, North American ice surface? Can he move from the right side to the middle? Check mark, check mark, check mark. I know it's just one game, and I know teams are going to zero in on him, but he seems to be one step ahead of the play, and that's what's just so captivating in this marketplace.
Kuz, we're going to get you a better line. We're just going to come back to you a second, because we're getting a little bit of breakup, okay? So just hang in there and come back to us, and we'll continue this conversation. But look, this is what Kuz is talking about. Is something that fans are going to get their head around. I agree with him. It's not that he hasn't been playing with grown men before, and it's not that he hasn't been challenged to go and get it to the next level.
Yeah, and in his season, he got better as the season went on.
As he learned that.
And it was a very shrewd move by the Canucks and Travis Green to try him out at center, because he's unshackled. He's able to use his hockey sense. Yeah. Whereas if he's going to be like battling along the boards every game and, just up and down the wing, and there might be a time this year where they move him to the wing just to give him another peek at another position. But as Kuz was talking about, and from my past experience playing down the middle, like if you want to involve yourself in the game, you've got free reign. And the thing about Pettersson, he has a unique ability to get close to a player and just kind of wrap that stick underneath and knock the puck free. And then he's usually the first guy on it.
We got Ben Kuzma back. So, Ben, I'm going to shift this over to Brock Boeser, because the love fest with Pettersson continues, okay? Boeser, who you could dismiss during preseason, okay, it's preseason, got it. But that performance against Calgary, to me, if you haven't got a red flag up, you've got one now. No shots. Forget the no goals, no shots, minus two, giveaways, all of it. How concerned should we be with Boeser? I believe, because of his competitive nature, that he is going to take his game back to where it's been, and I've got it happening on Saturday. You tell me.
Well, I always like to think that two things that Boeser has going for him is one is ability, Dave, and the other thing is he's got this attitude that he doesn't seem to get fazed by stuff. But what did concern me in the opener was the fact that there was a hesitancy there, yeah. A reluctancy to let that shot go. He had the puck in some prime shooting areas. And this is something he talked about even at training camp in Whistler, is the fact that he kept referencing the word confidence. And you just wonder, is there something else at play here? I mean, we know about the sophomore jinx. He had one in North Dakota. We know about the back injury. You wonder if everything's fine back there, because the 8 pounds he put on, and he jokingly said, I hope it's all muscle, has kind of slowed him a bit. He doesn't seem to have the explosiveness. When he does carry the puck, he used to be able to find time and space, and without even thinking, letting that shot go. All that's not there. And I don't care what happens Saturday in Calgary, even when it goes in off his butt, He just needs something to get his mojo going. But right now, what I see is a guy who's hesitating, lacking a little bit of confidence, and just doesn't have that explosiveness. And I think if he, you know, players naturally drop weight through the regular season, and I think those 8 pounds he put on, I think he'd be best served to get rid of them.
One player that seemed to shed a lot of weight, maybe just proverbially on their shoulders, was Jacob Markstrom. I thought he had a fantastic game. I said he was the best player in a Canuck uniform, and I'm wondering if just some of the incremental changes that Ian Clark has made so early through their talks over the summer have paid off and added a little bit of confidence to his game.
Well, let's see what happens Saturday in Calgary, okay?
Right.
I'm kind of in the show-me Jacob camp. The one thing he did mention talking to him after the opener is that the one thing that Clark has been doing a lot better than he did was puck tracking. That's, you know, that's a new thing for goalies, tracking the pucks. Rather than acting like a jack-in-the-box and looking around players and trying to figure out where the puck is, picking it up early and tracking it so you're not over-committing on the first shot. And I think that's been Markstrom's big foible in the past, is that he tends to overcommit in the shot, and when he's looking for that puck through legs and everything, he tends to open up the glove side. And all last year, players were purposely looking glove side on him because he'd be down low, he'd be looking for the puck, and that upper part of the net is open. That wasn't the case on Saturday night. I know in the third period, it got a little scrambly. I mean, they were outshot 17-6, but you got to give Markstrom props. And you think about an opener, everything that had to happen for the Canucks, I mean, they got the old offense. They got a 7-for-7 performance on the PK that was 21st ranked last year, and they got a 33 save performance from their starting or supposed or kind of starting goalie. You can't ask for a better night.
Shotgun Jake. How many shotguns are we going to have on Saturday night?
Well, the thing I like about Virtanen is people are wondering, why is he playing with Sutter and Mott? There was a point last year where Travis Keane purposely put Jake with Brandon Sutter in a kind of quasi-shutdown role, because how can you get Jake going in the offensive zone? How can you get that motor running? How can you get that big butt activated in terms of a heavy forecheck? Put him on a line where they've got to do a job. And when they were matched up against Monahan and Goudreau in the opener, I thought they did a really good job. Travis Green cited and said, might have been our best line.
Yeah.
So I've always been a proponent that Jake needs to be that guy, your third line right winger for now, to play well in transition, to get in on the forecheck, to be aggressive, because Jake's always one of these guys like, hey, I just did that. I can't believe I just stapled that guy to the wall. No, it has to be a tenacious 45-second shift. I think that's a good spot, and I think somebody's going to be shotgunning on Saturday. Jake played his junior there. He's ramped up. He's either going to get an apple or he's going to get a goal.